Let us study about EMF induced in a moving conductor in uniform magnetic field. Here you can see there is a uniform magnetic field induction B vector in which a conductor of length L is translating with a speed V. Now in this situation we can see that as if a conductor is moving with a speed V, within the conductor each free electron will also move with a speed V, and we can say each free electron of conductor experiences a magnetic force, and this magnetic force can be given as, if we write the force on each free electron as Fe, this can be written as EVB, because the electron is moving with a speed V perpendicular to the magnetic field. Now in this situation the direction of this magnetic force by right hand palm rule we can say, as being a negative charge, will be in downward direction. So we can say due to this magnetic force we can write here free electrons will drift toward Q, the and Q of the rod. So this will be slightly negative, and as electrons are shifted from point P it will become slightly positive. And due to these charges occurring by the drift of these electrons, an electric field is established in the conductor in downward direction, which can be written as an induced electric field. And due to this induced electric field, if we talk about this electron, in downward direction it was experiencing a magnetic force EVB, and due to drift of electrons an induced electric field is developed which applies an upward force EEI on the electron. So we can directly write due to this as a magnetic force, due to this magnetic force free electrons will drift toward Q, and this induces an electric field EI within the conductor, as we have just now discussed. And here we can say in a steady state implies continuously this induced electric field will increase due to the drift of electrons till this electric force will balance the magnetic force on electron. So no more drifting will take place. So in this situation, in a steady state, EEI will be equals to EVB, and this gives us the value of induced electric field, that is VB, which is a constant within the volume of this conductor. And due to this electric field we can see a potential difference is also induced across the ends P and Q. So here we can write the potential difference across the rod due to EI is, this can be written as VP minus VQ, and this we can simply write as EI multiplied by L, as EI is constant. And whenever electric field is constant in a region, potential difference can be calculated by product of magnitude of field and the separation between the points. So in this situation this can be written as BVL. And one important point here is, this potential difference is induced without any electrostatic causes. It is because of a magnetic force. So we can term this potential difference as an electromotive force. So here we can write it as an induced EMF, electromotive force due to motion of a conductor in magnetic field. This is denoted by small e across the end, which can be given as BVL. This is a very useful relation, and as it is due to motion of a conductor, this is also termed as a motional EMF, and this also forms a strong basis of many different kind of problems which are based on conductor motion in a magnetic field. We'll continue on the next sheet by getting the same motional EMF by using Faraday's law also. In continuation, let's discuss the explanation of motional EMF by using Faraday's law. We already studied in the Faraday's law that whenever there is a relative motion between a conductor and magnetic field, such that a conductor cuts magnetic lines, then EMF induced in the conductor can be given by rate of change or rate of cutting the magnetic flux. Here we can see as magnetic induction is B and the conductor is translating with a speed V. We can say in time dt it will travel a distance V dt and reach this position. And in this time dt we can say this is the area swept by the conductor. So, we can directly calculate the flux cut, magnetic flux cut by conductor in time dt is d phi, and this d phi we can write as b dot ds, which is the area in which we wish to find the magnetic flux. This will be b multiplied by, here the area can be directly given as lv dt. If this is the magnetic flux by Faraday's law, we can say EMF induced in conductor is, this can be given as E is mod of d phi by dt, and d phi by dt here we can directly see it is given as BVL, which is the motional EMF we already derived by using induced electric field. And here the direction of induced EMF can be directly given by right hand palm rule. Here right hand palm rule can be directly applied by placing your fingers along the direction of B vector, your thumb along the direction of velocity vector, and in this situation our palm face will point toward the high potential end of the conductor. Like in this situation, if I use my right hand fingers inward and thumb along the direction of velocity, my palm face is pointing toward P, and point P can be taken as high potential end and can be marked as positive, and Q, the low potential end, can be marked as negative.